I've heard lots of people say that Easter and other religious holidays are actually pagan and aren't actually biblical. So I'm wondering what you would say to the people who say those kinds of things, or what evidences you see for why we should celebrate them.
Well, I mean, obviously a really relevant question right now, isn't it, Taylor? And the first thing I would want to say is, Sunday, the Lord's Day, is the day that Jesus rose again from the dead. The reason Christians began meeting on Sundays early on, I mean, from the days of the apostles on, you see this in places like Acts chapter 20 and 1 Corinthians chapter 16, is because of the resurrection of Jesus. There was this great shift, if you will. And so they started to gather on Sunday, on the first day of the week, on the Lord's Day, to celebrate the fact that Jesus had risen from the dead. And so we're called as believers to celebrate the resurrection. It's the message of joy and hope. It's the cardinal truth of our faith. I mean, the Apostle Paul makes this absolutely clear in 1 Corinthians chapter 15. If Jesus Christ is not raised from the dead, we're still in our sins. We're lost. We're hopeless. So we ought to, as believers, celebrate the resurrection. Now, the question is, what do you think about one day out of the year really focusing on it? Something like Easter, that kind of a thing. And it is also historically the case that early on, believers did begin to celebrate the resurrection of Jesus on a particular time, a particular day of the year, where they would observe this sort of feast, this celebration of what they called Pascha. They didn't call it Easter. They referred to it as Pascha because it was the fulfillment of the Passover. And of course, the Apostle Paul says in 1 Corinthians chapter 5, we were just there talking about church discipline. 1 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 7, cleanse out the old leaven that you may be a new lump, as you really are unleavened, for Christ, our Passover lamb, has been sacrificed. Let us therefore celebrate the festival, not with the old leaven, the leaven of malice and evil, but with the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth. Jesus Christ is our Passover lamb, who through his exodus, if you will, brings us into new life through his death and resurrection. And in fact, Jesus's departure, his death, is referred to as an exodus. Really interesting, sort of echoing the scriptures in the Old Testament. In Luke's gospel at the Transfiguration in Luke chapter 9, verse 31, Jesus talked about his death as an exodus. And so Christians celebrated Easter on a particular day of the year. There were even debates in the ancient church about, what day that was in particular. And Christians were dividing over this, which I think is unfortunate, because instead of just focusing on the fact that Christ had risen, they were arguing about, what day specifically did he rise on. But the core truth is he's risen. He's risen. And because Jesus Christ rose again from the dead, we have the hope of the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Now, were there other celebrations, even pagan celebrations, around that same time of the year throughout the history of the church? Well, yeah, but the church wasn't trying to engage in those things. For Christians, historically, it really has been a focus on the resurrection of Jesus. I do sympathize with the concern of not wanting the worship of the church to be corrupted, not wanting sort of pagan religion, pagan ideologies to creep into the worship of the church. God cares about how he's worshiped. Hebrews chapter 12 makes this very clear. God wants to be worshiped with reverence and awe. And we have to be on guard that these false ideologies or religious beliefs don't creep into the church. But I don't think that the main problem is celebrating Pascha or Easter, the resurrection of Jesus. I think it's the consumerism that we see all around us in the church today. Not a high view of the Word of God, not a high view of sin. We were talking about that earlier on the program, Taylor. That's what we need to recover. We need to recover the core Christian doctrines, doctrines like the doctrine of the resurrection. And so I, for one, am excited to gather together with believers. And every Sunday we rejoice in the resurrection. But one thing I'll say that I actually appreciate about doing this, sort of annual celebration of the resurrection, Easter, Pascha, whatever you want to call it, is that it's an opportunity. There are a lot of people who don't go to church every Sunday or hardly at all, who might be open to showing up on Easter. And what an opportunity to invite friends and family members who ordinarily don't darken the door of a church or sit in a pew to come and hear a message of hope. The hope that we have, and especially in a year like the one we just sort of went through, where there's so much concern about death, mortality, it's sort of everywhere in front of us, to be able to bring to people the resurrection, to preach it, to share it, to encourage our friends and neighbors with the fact that death has been conquered. What a blessing. And so I'm excited about that, and I think that you can be as well. Thanks for your question.
You know, Adriel, I'm struck by the fact that most pastors, and I'm guessing this includes you as well, are very sensitive to the fact that people may be bringing friends or relatives to church on Easter, people who, as you said, would never darken the door of a church or may never have heard about God's love for them in the past. And so many pastors are particularly sensitive to that, and they sort of gear their sermon for the people that really don't have any background in the faith. What a great opportunity for all of us to be evangelistic this week and maybe take that extra step, that risk of inviting a friend or relative to go to church with us on Easter.
Yeah, I appreciate that you say that, Bill. As a pastor, I mean, I'm trying to encourage all of you listening right now, think about that, pray about that. Who's someone in your life that you could potentially say, hey, yeah, I've never invited you to church before, but this Sunday, you know, is Easter Sunday, and I'd love for you to join me. Yeah, I read a poll or a statistic some time ago that said that most people, if you invited them to church, would be willing to come. The thing is, we just don't invite them. And so, man, especially when on this Sunday in particular, a lot of pastors are going to be preaching on that core truth of the Christian faith, the resurrection of Jesus. It doesn't get more central than that. What an opportunity, as I said, after the year that we've just had, to really encourage someone. And you never know what the Lord will do in an individual's life. So invite your friends and come prayerfully and expectant to receive God's grace and His word. Hey friends, thanks for watching that video. I trust that it was encouraging to you. Please be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel if you're looking for more great content coming from Core Christianity. And if you haven't done so yet, would you give this video a like? It's one of the ways that we can continue to get the word out. So like this video and subscribe to our channel for more content. May the Lord bless you.